Accounting for financial instruments. Lecture number 3. Options. An option contract is an agreement between buyer, holder, and a seller that gives the holder a right but not the obligation to buy or sell a particular underlying at a predetermined price on or before a specific future date. There are two types of option contracts, call option and put option. Call option. A call gives the holder a right but not an obligation to buy a particular underlying at a predetermined price on or before a specific future date. Put option. A put gives the holder a right but not an obligation to sell a particular underlying at a predetermined price on or before a specific future date. You can use call option to purchase shares with a strike price $40, expiration date 31 July, or option will be valuable if the shares is trading above $40 per share on 31st of July. This is our second case study about call options that don't qualify for hedge accounting. So there is no hedging relationship, there is no hedging item or hedging instrument, only call option as a contract. On November 20, the APC company acquired from GigaBank an European call option on 100,000 francs at a strike price of $0.8, paying a premium of $0.008 per franc. The expiration date is December 20. Required. Explain the terms of the option contract. Number 2. Assuming a spot rate of $0.83 per franc and the fair value of the option was $3,000 on December 20. Prepare all journal entries to account for the option contract. Another assumption is a spot rate of $0.78 per franc on December 20. Prepare all journal entries to account for the option contract under the second or and the third assumption. First, we need to explain the terms of the option contract. The trade date was 20 November and the expiration date 20 December. The buyer APC company is a seller GigaBank. Option style, it's an European style. The type of option is a call option. Underlying 100,000 francs, strike price $0.8. Premium 100,000 francs multiplies by 0.008 per franc, resulting in $800. Call option gives the holder the right but not obligation to buy 100,000 francs with a strike price $0.8 on December 20. According to the first assumption, the spot rate is $0.83 on December 20. Therefore, the company will exercise the option because the company can purchase 100,000 francs at the price of 0.8 while the market price is $0.83. The table summarized the value of the option contract on November 20 and on December 20. The value of the option contract on November will be the premium, which is $800, and increased by the 20 December to $3,000 with a gain about $2,200. On November 20, we need to record the purchase option contract with premium 800. So the option will be debit with 800 and cash will be credit with 800. On December 20, we will adjust the option contract to its fair value. The option increased by 2,200 in this date. So the option will be debit with 2,200 and the gain from option contract will be credit with the same number. Finally, we will record the exercise of option by receiving foreign currency according to the market price, which is 0.83, and pay cash according to the strike price, which is 0.8, and settle the option contract with value of $3,000. Call option gives the holder the rights, but not the obligation, to buy 100,000 francs with a strike price $0.8 on December 20. According to the second assumption, the spot rate is $0.78 on December 20. Therefore, the strike price 0.8 is greater than the spot price 0.78. The company will not exercise the option. This is our table to summarize the value and the change in value of the option contract. On November 20, the value of the option contract will be the premium, which is $800. But on December 20, the value will be zero, because I'm not going to exercise the option. On November 20, option will be debit with the premium, and the cash will be credit with the same number. On December 20, the company decided not to exercise the option, so the option will be credit with 800, and loss from option contract will be debit with the same number.